Like, remember that nice pacing thing I was talking about, where it's like there's stealth sections, vehicle sections, shoot 'em out sections, and then you got like sections where they force you to use Covenant weapons, and then it's just this, which is just like
flood all the time.
Run around in circles for an hour.
Yep. Just to collect a little green thingy that's basically a MacGuffin.
If it was half the length, it would be a good level, though.
Mm.
I feel like it would be. Unless, maybe if there was more, like... Yeah, I don't know.
You see, this is the thing, though. I think what this level is trying to do is to showcase how weary it is to actually fight the Flood as a threat. Like, if you read the novel, it actually emphasizes that. Like, by the end of this level in the novel, the Master Chief is exhausted. Like, he's like, his head is on a swivel, everything's going horribly wrong. Remember the explosion form behind you? You almost blundered into that.
Oh.
I love these explodey guys. They're like, yeah, let's kill everyone around us.
I don't know, I remember they pulled a really lame thing in the novel. Yeah. They're just like, your suit has a power level of 5. You need a suit of power level that's 50 or something like that.
Yeah, Guilty Spark says that
really
in the novel.
Lame.
It's like,
I was like,
what?
Are you kidding me?
Okay, so then why are they dead then? If they had more, if they had power suits.
First of all, second of all, goddammit, like, don't make your book like into some video game that's not even like Halo. Like, We don't need Dragon Ball Z to suddenly drop into this equation.
Well, it's good thing that grenade didn't land right at your feet.
I really don't like when they do stuff like that so blatantly, like...
Oh, our world is bigger. Really,
yeah.
It is.
Well, it's not even that it's bigger. It's just like, oh, that suit that's so cool, well, let's just one-up it through some sort of, like, throwaway dialogue,
mm-hmm.
You know? Like, okay, so first of all, you don't show us that cool thing, so, like, we have no context of how cool it actually is, besides the fact that now the thing that we thought was cool is now lame. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was epic. I love the explodey.
Nice grenade.
Explodey guys. I call them the explodey guys. I want to call them the Pillsbury Doughboys, but they don't react well when you get close to them. That was a joke. That was my attempt at humor.
Yeah. No, don't worry. I was quiet on purpose. My being quiet on purpose was my humor.
I'm being shot. Help me.
I am helping.
You have vibrate on your phone, on your controller,
yes,
don't
I do.
You?
Yes, I do.
Narm.
Yeah, the Xbox One vibrate is pretty intense, to say the least.
I'm freaking out, man.
Yeah.
Actually, weird little bit of trivia. Just to interrupt for a second to try and get this level to a bit of a more respectable state. Shotguns! In this game, the plasma weapons are actually more effective than they are in Halo 2 against the Flood.
Yeah.
But then they mysteriously changed that to make the plasma weapons the most effective weapon against the Flood in the Halo 3.
Yeah.
Which was weird, beyond
all sense. Well, you could also headshot the Flood in Halo 3 with projectile weapons if you shot them in the chest.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
You can actually do that here with the pistol, actually.
It's not nearly as reliable, and it kind of feels like it's one of those things.
It almost feels like a fluke, but it is there. You can do it.
Like how, it's the same sort of thing where, like the shotgun, how it actually used pistol coating.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that? So you can actually get, like, really far distance headshots with the shotgun.
Well, yeah, each pellet does the damage of a single pistol shot, too, up close.
Yeah. Shit, okay.
Did you almost jump down?
No, I almost got full blasted by a needler.
that vibration is actually kind of...
It is, it's really funny.
He's like, nah.
Mm.
Man, you got a secret lover you want to tell us about? Is that your cell phone going off all around?
Yeah.
Maybe you should jump off this cliff to show her your undying affection for her.
You jump off.
Oh, you can jump off. Oh, by the way, neat little bit of AI quirks.
What?
If you had left that Flood explodey thing alive...
Okay.
There would have been a Flood explodey guy over there, and he would have actually, like, done a double take and hid behind one of these pillars to hide from you.
Really?
Like, it's actually kind of funny to see those explodey things guys go like, hey, this is not my fight, and they're just running away. It's actually funny. I love it. It's a quirk.
Pew pew. Pew 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 pew. Something that's left out of a lot of games nowadays, eh?
Yeah, I mean... I think the reason...
Like, everything has to be an Easter egg now.
Yeah.
You know? Oh, it's an Easter egg. It shows, like, this thing...
It shows we have a sense of humor.
From another game that we made.
You're going the wrong way.
Ugh, Jesus Christ, it's a circle.
Yeah, but there's only two doors.
All right. Well, I thought there are three, but one of them's a dead end. Ooh. There we go. Where'd you get that shotgun?
I picked it up off the floor, like all good acquisition of weaponry.
Yeah.
You just find shit lying around.
That's what Borderlands taught me.
You want a shotgun? Oh, shit!
Yeah, I do.
The fuck was...
I do want a shotgun, Kyle.
Oh, look at the human combat form fully mutilated.
Mm.
And then look... Oh, what the fuck?
No, I think that's better. I honestly think it's better.
Why?
Because that looks like a cartoon zombie, and that looks better. I don't know, like it looks too cartoony.
I would argue that this looks more cartoony.
Cartoon? No, look at this. It's just like...
This looks like those are the freaking things from The Last of Us.
The Last of Us is not cartoony.
Whatever.
Make up your mind.
Shut up.
Don't contradict
Shut
yourself.
Shut up. I blasted your arm off. Did you like that?
Boom.
All that... Actually, the explodey guys are made out of grunts.
Yes.
You can actually see it if
their
you look closely at their legs.
Yeah.
Ah, got it. It actually makes it kind of disturbing when you see them attack grunts that point. It's like, ew, you're cows. You're literally...
Aren't they elite cows? Remember they used to call elites cows? Remember that?
No, I don't remember that. Actually.
Oh, that was a Halo... I believe it started in Halo 2. I believe that was a term for anyone who played...
Yeah, because the hitboxes,
yeah.
You couldn't headshot them from behind.
Yeah.
That was retarded,
well,
actually.
Also, they were also crouched down low, so it was easier to hit them.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it would stick out forward, so it was dumb.
But I think the counterbalancing factor was they could soak up a whole shotgun shell and actually die to it, so... Apparently.
I don't know if there was any different, like, damage that happened. All I know is that it was, like, inferior to the Spartan, because you could also do what's called strong sighting. And that is looking down when you run away so that your head goes down and then you can't get headshot.
Yeah, but you had to actively look down, which impeded your tactical abilities. With the elites, I believe, and I actually can't confirm this right now, but I believe it used to be the case that in Halo 3, yeah, the hitboxes were such that you couldn't headshot the elites from behind.
Or
was it Halo 2?
Probably both, maybe. I don't know. All I remember is that they were just worse, both of them. Cows.
Cows.
I forgot about that until you said cows.
Well, we do know that the cows had to go somewhere once they were abducted, right?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, aliens.
Aliens. It explains everything, you know. Everything is explained.
Good joke.
Donald Trump's presidency.
Aliens?
Yeah, aliens.
I'd chalk it up to aliens. They're, like, testing us. They're like, let's see if they're ready.
Let's see if we can get the dumbest person imaginable elected to the most powerful position in the world. If it actually happens, we have to kill humanity to save themselves. Millions will die.
I'm moving to Australia. Or maybe Scandinavia, where things are, where they use things like analytics and science. So,
well, yeah. I would move to Australia just because you can use cunt as like a form of punctuation and not have it actually be taken as an insult.
I guess,
how you doing, you cunt?
Yeah, but they don't like the word bitch there.
They can go fuck... Where's the door? There's supposed to be a door here. Oh, the door. The big door.
Oh.
The big door.
Oh, I was just like...
This was
around.
The endless spawning flood.
I felt like we were playing a firefight for a sec. I was just fucking around. Like, literally, I forgot that we were supposed to go somewhere.
3-4 through Guilty Spark. What do you think of him as a character?
He's alright. I mean, he's cool. Right?
I mean, barring that his last appearance in Halo 3 when he was just a pushover boss.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't regard that, really. He's barely in that game. No, he's cool.
He's an insane robot. I like that. Who doesn't love insane robots?
Yeah.
You brought such ineffective weapons to combat the flood, despite the containment protocol.
We have a shotgun. 3-4-3 Guilty
your
Spark.
Your shotgun's only level 5. You need at least a level 12 shotgun.
You know, I think a shotgun is doing just fine in this situation, sir. I don't think you realize how stupid the words you just said sounded coming out of your mouth.
So you'd think, because in the continuity of the rest of the Halo games, there are totally, like, Forerunner weapons. You'd think they'd have Forerunner weapons lying around the Halo.
Yeah.
So if you were to say something like that...
Where are these superior weapons,
yeah.
Guilty Spark? Okay. Oh, I'm sorry!
Thank you.
Oh, f-
Oh my god. You're gonna blow out the mic.
I'm sorry. That was just awesome to watch. I love those little chain reactions. This game had them.
Yeah, no, this game had chaos, which is why the multiplayer is still so fun. Games don't seem to... Like, games hate chaos now. Yeah. I think it's because people tend to complain about them more.
Yeah, it's like, we want you to view this specific incident in this specific way, or else it's not fun.
Well, I don't know.
You're tired. Drink some more Coke.
Yeah, I should.
Do some more cocaine.
I should, yeah.
Like,
clean design is good. Like, everybody likes clean design and shit like that. But clean design, in a lot of cases, because game design is getting to be more and more of a science, like, clean design is very, like, put on a pedestal, pretty much, right? You know? And people forget to test out if a game's, like, fun. And you know what? It doesn't help that marketing finds its way into being a facet of game design now.
Mm-mm.
Because, I mean, that's just the truth. Game designers are pressured into making decisions based off of financial... What are you doing?
I'm letting them pop on my shield.
Based off a financial gain. And I'm not even talking about microtransactions. I'm talking about...
Make this character cuter so we can sell more dolls. Please.
Yes. It's that plus a lot more. Plus the thing.
Plus... Also, Call of Duty had kill streaks. You should have some of these there, too.
No, that's a different subject. That's the whole design by...
Whoa, two flood in one shot. That was
follow
good.
The leader, and you end up getting this, like, blind following the blind effect.
Yeah.
Because no one remembers why the change was made in the first place, and I did touch on the last time we were recording about... Oh, shit. About the, why regenerating health is a thing. It's because of, consoles having... Like, not just because of Halo 2, obviously, but the reason it worked and was give it was with... Ah, I'm losing my words.
Yes, you are.
I'm trying to shoot at things, and I'm also trying to speak. It's hard.
Hey, a good YouTuber would know how to do such things.
Yeah, I'm not a good YouTuber.
Why do I work with you? Why do I tolerate you?
So, I know I'm also reiterating a point, but the difference is that Halo 2 put it in for a reason... And everyone else who saw Halo 2's success with it assumed that its success was because of the change, rather than, you know, the other way around. Therefore...
Like, success begets success, in quotation marks.
Well, follow the leader design philosophies suck. Mm-hmm. You have to know what you're doing. Because if you do something for no reason, and you can't justify why you're doing it, it's probably not the best choice. And I mean that in the way of, like, you could probably find a better choice. I don't mean that as in like the passive aggressive, like it's automatically bad.
Yeah.
Because it might not be automatically bad, you don't know. It could just work out a fluke. There are happy accidents. But
generally, I think the library looks better, if only because it's not just an MLC of brown.
They
and
always
blue.
Keep doing this for all their things. It's just like that texture. Oh shit. The lighting's better. The lighting's better in most of the remastered levels.
Whoa. Obviously, the particle effects are too, but that's just a reflection of the times more than anything, is it?
Yeah, I mean, the Xbox 360 could actually handle the, you're just standing there.
Well, they don't do any damage to you. I mean, come on. I'd rather not waste the ammo. I mean, yeah, it's kind of unsettling having these creepy little jellyfish.
Are we done yet?
Ah!
This fucking level.
Are we done yet? We're only on the first floor, dude.
Oh,
calm
God.
Down.
Oh, God.
What did you think? This was a fun level?
I forgot there's elevators.
Oh, shit. Oh, you literally walked into the knife. Sorry.
No, it's half my bed. Half your bed. I mean...
I was trying to shoot a flood who literally was right behind you.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Shenanigans.
Oh, I'll get this.
You get the overshield. You deserve it.
Because you killed me, you bastard.
Wait, look at all this.
I think my
shotgun... Look at all this. What the fuck?
Yeah.
That is just stupid.
We need lines, and they need to be glowing.
We need lines everywhere. This is alien architecture.
These shapes are fucking... everywhere. Anytime something's like the future, it's like 45 degree angles and straight lines.
Like, what purpose do these squiggly lines serve? Are they information? Are they wires? Do they send something somewhere? Or are they just there for decoration?
They're just emissives. They're, like, we need glowy bits.
The fucking arrow.
arrows too.
They look, to be fair, they look better on these, and these look a bit like servers, so that's kind of cool. But like,
well, they still look like computers in the old version.
Yeah, but I mean that's a nice addition because like, look, these still were kind of like glowy a little.
Ah,
I don't know. Don't know what I'm saying anymore.
No, I don't think anyone knows what you're saying. Oh shit, I'm about to die. I gotta run like a bitch.
This level is numbing, and I'm also numbed from lack of sleep.
Well, that's your fault, isn't it?
Oh,
watch out! Ah! Holy shit, that guy flew!
Yeah, no
kidding. That was a horde in one!
Physics.
The pistol...
Canada, eh?
The pistol, I actually don't know which version to prefer.
What?
Looks-wise, the pistol.
Inconsequential. They look fine. It looks good.
It's not a faithful, consequential.
It's a faithful recreation.
Okay, fine.
Look at it.
Look at the little cute little flood forms.
Yeah, that's totally cool. I mean, there's yellow dots, sure, but...
Research facilities are most impressive.
Halo.
It's like, what do you want? Do you want a red triangle or do you want yellow dots? That's it.
Let's stick with the new one for this library version. How about all right, that?
All right.
The punishment being that if we both die again at the same time, well, we have to switch it back. The library, for all intents and purposes, isn't an awful level. It's just a numbing level.
It's not awful, but it is the weakest level
in
this game.
I'm trying to think of a rough comparison.
It's like Novaria from fucking Mass Effect 1.
Ah, shit. Wait, you didn't like Novaria?
No.
I love Novaria.
Oh, dude.
Did you die?
Yeah, I did. I walked off the edge.
You're not dead.
What?
Oh, now you are.
Yeah, I'm totally dead.
You took a long time to fall.
Cinematics, I guess.
Oh, shit!
Oh, no.
Oh, fuck! Oh!
Oh, jeez.
We have to switch it back.
Ah, fuck. Okay.
Don't fall.
Yeah. I thought there was glass.
Never assume there's glass.
Yeah,
what are you, crazy?
Apparently. Do you ever get the feeling, like, people are forgetting to make a game...
fun?
Well, yeah. I guess I did touch on that. But, I mean, like, gamey. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it should be a video game, right? Not a souped-up film that someone wants to make a prestige picture out of.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, this is an Oscar bait. This is a video game.
Yeah, well, see, I like games with stories and a narrative and the meaning and all that good stuff. But, like, if you're... I don't know. I'm so split on it because, like, I do like it, and I am totally of the philosophy where it's just, like, if you can make it fun... you know, like, you should do it. But then, like, at the same time, like, games don't have to be quote-unquote fun. Like, it's, like, it's supposed to be interactive. That's the point, right?
Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, yes, there have been a few indie games and stuff released through the past years that have basically been nothing but text adventures, and they've been praised for that.
Yeah, but, I mean, that's all fine and dandy, but... there's such a distinction between a narrative-focused game and a game like, let's say, League of Legends. Right?
Yeah.
But they fall under the same domain. Domain. Can you think of, like, a movie that's as distinctive from, like, Go Home to League of Legends? Can you think of two movies?
Like, Gone Home, you mean?
Did I say Grow Home?
Yeah, you said Go Home. I'm like,
oh,
that's actually a completely different game.
I was thinking
Gone Home to
but
League
I was
Legend?
Also thinking Grow Home, and
you would
then
have
I said
to, like,
Go Home.
You would have to switch genres of film to get it.
It's more than
radically
genres,
different.
Though. It's more than genres because, like even within
art
the same...
films, like art house films, maybe, and the difference between art house film like Andy Warhol's like Empire, where it's basically just
but...
one 48-minute film just of a single shot of the Empire State Building.
Oh no.
No!
Oh,
you'll zoom.
Okay. Well, here's my point. And, like, you can split it into genre, but here's the way the medium is digested. Is still, even though you have your long-ass Andy Warhol film, it's still a subject of, like, it's visual. It's all visual. Film.
It's a film,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but, like, League of Legends versus... like the ways it is digested compared to Gone Home is completely different. Like, I would almost, like, I don't want to strip away the name game, but it's getting to a point where, like, the name itself almost doesn't mean anything anymore, you know? Like, it's such a broad statement, it's hard to say. Like, it's not a description anymore. Let
I
me
think
just say
it's
that.
Almost to the medium's strength. Like,
I mean, what other medium can you say is as malleable as video games are?
No, exactly. But at the same time, I'm like, I'm kind of like a stickler for definitions, and I don't mean, like, if I were to say, like, oh, I don't consider Gone Home, like, a game in, like, a game sense, that's not to its detriment.
Oh, like, by the way, because you said that, that means you're a sexist, misogynist asshole, just for saying that it's not a game.
Yeah, but,
so,
of course.
Just so you know.
Of course, but I mean, what I'm getting at, really, is, like, if we call it something, like, interactive story, interactive medium, interactive something, it doesn't matter what we call it, that's... But, like, it's so strange that there's that massive, massive distinction.
Did you die?
I'm rambling. My point is that I actually don't have a point, but I'm just kind of like...
Do you ever have a point?
No, I ramble. Usually I think I have a
point. I am a rambling man.
Usually I think I have a point, but I install too much context into what I'm saying that I lose my initial
Don't worry,
point.
It's my fatal flaw, too. I've been told to shut up.
Well, I prefer context to actually making a point, if that makes any sense.
Well, of course, the context makes your argument stronger, so I actually respect your ability to do that.
I guess.
See, we're having a civil conversation, I think. I'm on one thing of health, and I've died less than you.
That's nice.
For shame.
Good job.
Air shot, bitch!
I need a shotgun. Oh, he has a shotgun right there.
Grab it.
Perfect.
Even though...
Excellent. So yeah, if I were to make something, let's say I were to make a Patreon.
Yeah.
Okay? And I were to make something that was like Gone Home, but even less... Like, what was that game where you're basically... Thomas Was Alone. Isn't that just like a linear, like, experience the story through moving forward sort of thing?
No. Thomas Was Alone is a bit of a platform.
Oh, okay,
puzzle
yes.
Puzzle platform.
What was the one I was thinking of then?
The Stanley Parable, Dear Esther...
No, the Stanley Parable has a little more going on to it.
Dear Esther, probably.
No, it's literally like a 2D... I guess you could call it a platform without platforms, and it's just like telling a story as you go through, but it you know, it's a quote-unquote game. Like, if I were to make that and then not call it a game, but it's like still interactive and it's a story, you think people would get mad at me?
I'm trying to think of the game you're talking about now.
Do you know
it's gonna bug me.
Do you know what I am talking about, though?
Yes, okay. Like the whole genre of emergent exploration, right? It's...
Well, no, because like Journey and Dear Esther and stuff, you at least have, like, you can push a direction and then you do the thing, right? But you can do it in different orders.
Mm.
Not Journey, but...
Oh, I know the game you're thinking of now.
It's literally a straight line and you just experience the story and you have no consequence in it. So it's interactive, but it always tells the same story. If I were to make one of those and not call it a game, do you think people would get mad at me?
Mm. Well, I think... A lot of it comes down to authorial intent nowadays.
I
mean, we as a society have started to place more weight on auteur theory and all
actually,
that sort of things.
I kind of think it's the opposite. Like, the entire, like, analyzation of novels and breaking down of stories goes directly against authorial intent. For instance, Peoples is insisting that the Lord of the Rings is, like, an allegory to capitalism. Because it works, right? And that's what people can get out of it.
Well,
but,
that's also like a line of theory. But if we're talking about film, the dominant theory for the past, let's say, 20 years has been auteur theory. And since video games have aspired to be like film in many ways...
Kind of annoyingly.
It kind of almost fits... Because I analyze video games partially, not fully, through the mirror of auteur theory. And trying to figure out what this game is about, what it's doing, what it's capable of doing.
Yeah...
Oh, please wait here. That means we're going to face more flood. That's
nice.
Wonderful. Yes. Oh, there's a terminal. I can't remember if it's on this level or the level above us.
We get to access the Halo channel?
Yeah, I don't want to do that. So let's
I don't either.
But just so anyone knows, if you want to access that, basically go into one of these back areas and jump over these big support areas that I'm zooming in on. And you should eventually find a terminal. Maybe even a skull. I'm not quite sure. I haven't taken the time to explore the HD collection for the skulls.
Yeah, I haven't either.
Because it's, you know, Halo 1 didn't have skulls, goddammit.
God dang it. Shakes
Get
cane.
Off my lawn!
Shake my cane at you.
Shake my cane spear, bitch. My cane spear. Is there a cane spear in existence?
A cane spear?
Cane spear!
I'm
want
sure
one
there
now.
Is. There is a cane that has, like, a hidden sword.
That doesn't
you
have
can...
the same ring as a cane spear. Holy shit!
I mean, no, but...
This guy has two shotguns! Oh, there he goes. There's the guy running away. Love it. he just turns around and it's just like, fuck.
Did I get him?
Yeah, you got him.
Nice.
Oh, I love that. AI quirks, people. I think this reiterates a point I was going to say earlier on, but we kind of lost the train. I think the reason a lot of people like Halo and why I prefer a Halo single-player campaign is that it's AI. It may not necessarily be the best in any situation, but it has lots of quirks and personality flaws to it that I just love. I think most people love the grunts, the jackals, the various little quirks of the elites.
Well, yeah, they give each faction a personality.
Mm-hmm. Even the Flood have these little explodey guys running the fuck away from you.
Yeah, it's not just like AI runs at you and then shoots you.
I think this game, I mean, because Half-Life 1 and Half-Life 2 sort of still had that problem. Like, Halo 1 was the first game, I think, where AI mattered in terms of your enemies.
Ah!
Yeah, but they still didn't explore, like, the full depth of what can be done in Halo. Like, it sort of locked you to a certain playstyle because of how the AI... I mean, that's going to happen in any game.
But I think the AI added enough personality and quirk and chaos to everything that it almost makes Halo 1 a vital campaign experience no matter which random AI seed you get.
Well, if I were to make a video game course, this game would be in it.
Mm-hmm. Like, this, I think if we're gonna establish, like, a definitive canon, the first Super Mario Brothers, Halo... Oh, shit!
Shit. Oh, God.
Like, you know the first Super Mario Brothers, right?
No, I have no idea.
You jerk. Because a lot of people would say, oh, you mean like Super Mario Brothers 3? Fuck Super Mario Brothers 3. That game is way too hard for its crazy graphics. That's, okay?
I don't think it's that hard at all.
Shut up.
You're the reason they never brought Super Mario 2.
Yeah, sure. Blame the autistic kid for your problems.
No, blame the one who thinks Mario Super Mario Land 3 is. Is it Super Mario Bros. 3?
No, it's Super Mario Brothers 3, not Super Mario Land. I actually don't mind Super Mario World.
Yeah. Land or World? Land is it?
I think it's World.
No, yeah, World is with Yoshi. Oh, you can just... Fuck right off. Oh, God.
Be careful, there's a Flood with a rocket launcher that spawns somewhere.
Just the ones with assault rifles have freaking deadly accuracy with them. It's crazy.
That you can never have.
Yeah. But they, for some reason, also shoot it way slower, and,
like in the end, they're not major threats, but they're annoying.
Yeah. Wow. Whoa. Oh, wow.
I think the issue a lot of people have with this is just the endlessness of the waves. It's like, we just fought through three waves in the same damn nook.
Yeah, I mean, like, my brain hurts, right?
Yeah. Your brain actually hurts?
Brain hurts. Also, cyan? Orange. Cyan? Orange.
Fuck you, 343.
Orange and cyan.
At least this says purple.
Because choosing a color...
Holy shit!
Yo, real talk. Choosing a color palette is so hard. Just pick two colors that are on opposite ends of the wheel, and then you can not do any work.
Mm-hmm. Oh! I shot him the exact second he killed us.
Oh.
Oh. Fucking rocket launcher, right? Flood, man. I hate
over
them.
Here. Over here. I'm gonna take him up before...
No, he's at the end.
Yeah, I'm gonna take him up. Oh! Did he just point blank me with a shotgun?
Yeah, I think he did.
He did like a 1080 no-scope.
Well, I think half the shields were down, too, and that contributed to it.
Yeah, probably.
Man, look at all these particle effects coming out of these things when they explode. Look at that!
Oh.
It's confetti!
Not enough. Not enough particle effects.
You can never have enough.
Nope. Look.
I think that's where they got the inspiration for the...
green and purple. Like, I like it. Like, I know these are blue.
Oh, look, a Flood Buddy! We have a Flood Buddy.
Nice.
Say hello to my new friend. He's lovely, and he's nutritious, and he's very delicious.
Orange inside.
He also thirsts for your brains.
He just hit me.
No, he didn't. That was the Flood form.
Oh.
You jerk. Don't hurt my Flood Buddy. Come on. He's following you. He's a loyal pet.
Enough of your shenanigans. There's a rocket launcher right there.
I think this was the guy who shot you with the shotgun, too.
Was it?
Yeah.
Like this shotgun?
Yeah.
And then he ran, like, right at you?
Yeah.
Revenge.
There you go. Oh, there's your corpse.
Rest in peace.
pieces.
Yeah, rest in pieces.
I totally did now just want to like paint my coffin in Reese's Pieces colors. I could be like Reese's Pieces, man.
Reese and pieces.
I don't know, some kind of pun like that.
Yeah.
I want to go out in a pun in a way that can be told in a legendary pun. Okay?
Didn't someone make their coffin like? Oh, someone was talking about it. Like, they wanted to sort of like pull an archaeological prank and make their grave like a Twix wrapper, make it look exactly like a Twix wrapper.
Silly rabbit. Twix are for kids.
Something like that. That would be fun. More dudes behind you.
I always need more dudes behind me. Wait. Shit!
Oh, boy.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. So many explosions. Oh, yeah. God.
Oh, God. Oh, there's green goo all over you.
Yeah, I'm not gonna make that joke.
What is...
I'm not gonna make that joke.
This level
just goes on.
I don't miss it.
Yeah.
Okay, don't ditch me.
Yeah. I think the great Orson Welles described a great film as a movie with three great scenes and no bad ones. Halo has 9 great levels and 1 terrible one.
That's Do you not think terrible. That's still... That's not terrible. How can you say that? Have you ever played Legendary? Every level in Legendary is the library, but it's worse.
Oh, you're talking about the game Legendary. I thought you were talking about the difficulty.
No, we're playing on Legendary. No, the game Legendary.
I haven't played it yet.
Why did you spend money on a game like Legendary?
Because you told me to get some perspective on...
Yes, I did. Because you kept saying things like, this is the best of all time, the greatest of all time, the worst of all time. And I was like, dude, play some shitty games. And then come to me and talk to me about the worst of all time. And then, like, playing a bad game has, like, such a weird effect on, like, your perspective. Because you get, like, really fundamentally and philosophically confused. You're just like, how can this exist?
Human beings made this. Do we deserve to exist at all as a species?
Like, how did this... Like, and then it breaks down, like... You start to realize that maybe, like, people who are... professionals aren't like
are getting paid to do this
the end all be all, because someone, it wasn't just like one guy, because there had to be like a producer, and there had to be like someone who put money into the project and someone who backed it, and like, you know, you have to have a publisher who's willing to actually print your garbage. Maybe not so much nowadays with Steam Greenlight, like actually fuck Steam Greenlight, but
you know, there's a lot more options.
You get my point. Like a game like Legendary, where you're just like, how did this happen?
Who gave the green light to this piece of shit?
Yeah. And then, like, you start to realize what's just mediocre and gives you no feeling, and then what's actually bad. And most things you'll find are just, like, mediocre. Like, Assassin's Creed is totally, like...
Yeah. A lot of people were actually defending Assassin's Creed 3. I know I brought it up before, but seriously, fuck those people.
You won't stop bringing it up.
Because I was proven right, and you know what? I will gloat.
Alright, said Assassin's Creed 3 was bad on the internet before everyone else thought it was bad.
Oh, shit!
Congratulations!
I almost stuck you! Oh, did you see that?
Yes, I did. That was some Halo 2 grenade shenanigans, holy fuck.
Oh, that was glorious.
Anyway, apparently Ubisoft is stepping away from Assassin's Creed for a while because they want to re-envision it or some shit like that. You know what I hear from... You know what I hear? I hear... We are planning on making a line of mobile games that are Assassin's Creed themed. And also,
what have you got against mobile, people? God.
What do I have against mobile?
Do you have against people with mobility issues?
Mobile, like the mobile market, is run by non-gamers. Like, I don't mean that in like a gamers rule sort of way. I mean that in like they're businessmen. Like anything that you can qualify as artistic vision, except for like the very, very, very rare case, like maybe Monument Valley and stuff.
I was gonna bring up Monument Valley.
Yeah, exactly. But for the most part, like I was saying to you just a little while ago, a very sad statistic, how Clash of Clans was last year the second most high grossing game money wise in the world. Second only to League of Legends.
And I told you the very next sentence, why do you begrudge success so much?
Because it's success in spite of the consumer. Because it's not, you're not You're not playing a game. You are playing a money-wasting simulator.
You're playing your credit card.
You are playing a slot machine in which you can get shinier pictures than the other person, and then you compare shiny pictures, and then you can see that this person paid more money for the shinier picture.
So, Pokemon?
And then it flashes red on your screen. You win, you win, you win. And then you feel good. It's like, it's not... Like, yeah, okay, it's wrapped up in the skin of a game, but it's not... It's not designed like you think of regular games. It's weird. It's hard to explain. Once you sort of like,
so your essential argument is that this isn't actually what we would define as a game in the traditional sense.
It's a consumable.
Okay, so it's like a chocolate bar.
It's yes, sort of.
Meant to be consumed quickly and nothing else.
It is a chocolate bar that you can then extend so you don't run out.
Hey, would you like me to, like, add some freshly chewed chocolate bar to your chocolate bar? Yeah.
But even that's weird, because people can make the argument just like, oh, well, you know, you buy chocolate bars because they're good. Like, don't you buy games because they're fun? Like, it's different. It's...
Holy shit, there's a fuck ton of flood behind us! Oh, God!
When you view it from the other side of the window, it becomes much more obvious exactly how sort of sterile the whole thing is.
Okay, let's just let these flood combat forms pop.
All right, have fun.
Also, just for a quick walkthrough for people, you may have noticed when I immediately turned this corner, I chucked a grenade at this corner. That's because there's like a flood with a rocket launcher form at close range who comes around this corner, so you want to preempt that as much as possible.
See how I'm rushing ahead like this? It means I have no idea what I'm doing.
He does give... He's the giver of no fucks.
Yeah.
Also, I'm gonna try a rocket launcher.
Shit.
Yeah! America!
Good job.
Fuck yeah! He flew. America! Fuck yeah!
Anyways, the whole pay-to-play thing is... I mean, the whole pay-to-win thing. Like, it's devious. Like, like I was telling you, they get legit, like, psychoanalysts to fucking, like, make things as addicting and just as...
Holy shit, that...
just as suggestive as possible.
Okay, the needler is good at medium range against flood combat. Well,
yeah, because
okay.
It explodes. Yeah, anyway.
Multiple times! But this, I do understand the position. Like, microtransactions are bad, obviously.
Well, no, microtransactions are not bad. Pay to win is bad.
Yay, health pack!
It is absolute poison.
Alright, so pay to win is bad. It's not the tool, it's the person who utilizes it.
Yeah.
Alright, so Clash of Clans is a bad game.
Well, yes.
There.
I mean, think about it this way. You're almost like... It's like Pokemon, but instead of gotta catch them all, you're battling the other guy with your dollar bills. Only your dollar bills look like archers.
You know what I mean? Sorry, I just got caught up in the moment.
Okay.
Squeezing the trigger.
Did you hear what I said?
Yeah. Okay. Your money is archers.
You're fighting your $5 bill against his $10 bill. They're having a battle.
But wait, he quips so many spectacular lines.
What are you talking about?
Archers! Like, a whole army of archers? That'd be amazing! So, you could have that guy quipping all day.
Oh, I see what you're doing. You're making a joke.
It was funny.
Hilarious. No, don't worry, Kyle. You'll get it.
No one finds my jokes funny. They're not jokes, they're references.
It's fine. Even though I was completely silent, I was smiling. So, you can feel good about yourself.
I mean, do you find this level terrible?
I have lost all sense of progression in this level at this moment. And I feel like it should have ended.
Probably
that last elevator ride is where the end of the level should have been.
Yeah.
Like, I get it. At this point,
like, this level even has the temerity to actually, like, snark at itself on the last elevator. It says, like, finally! Or one of these levels, it's like, elevators. You'll notice it
totally.
Whoa, those corpses just came out of nowhere.
Yeah, they ragdoll. Well, not really ragdoll, but you know.
This game still has so much just... Oh, this is the part.
Is this the,
This is the alcove. Here's the one winning trick you need to know, people, to beat this part of the beat this part of the level.
Five weird
tricks. No. What? In the doors. There you go. Here's the only trick you need to know in order to beat this part of the level, which is actually pretty damn tricky on Legendary, I gotta say.
Game designers hate him. Ten weird tricks to beat the library.
Did you also know teabagging is an art form?
Number four will blow your mind. BuzzFeed's the worst.
What are you doing?
I will deactivate the security lock.
Okay, here. Okay, back up.
Yep, I know.
So if you do this right, even in the original Halo, look at me when I'm talking to you. If you do this right in the original Halo, even in there, nothing should come and attack you except maybe some infection forms. And then this, considered one of the hardest parts of the game if you try and fight it out, actually becomes a damn cakewalk.
Or you mean a kickstand?
That was funny. That was actually a joke. Good.
It's alright. You should do stand-up. What is that texture behind me? Oh my god.
Original textures. Oh wait,
what is that texture?
Oh, I thought this was the HD version.
Okay, I was about to say. I think they got rid of it. I think they were just that's bad. Like, that is a good choice by 343.
That's one good choice by 343.
Yeah.
Ooh. I like that shotgun.
See, it looks good from, like, your perspective, but from mine, it looks awful.
It looks like you're carrying a BB gun.
It feels like I'll shoot firecrackers.
Yeah, doesn't it? But damn.
Yeah, that's nice from your screen, though. Like, it's not bad.
Even in the original version, it looks damn imposing, does it not?
It looks like a redneck shotgun, though. I always found that kind of funny. You know what I mean? Like, that looks like a tactical shotgun. This looks just like they outfitted a shotgun with a...
It loads from the top. Do you not understand how important this is?
Is it important? What if I killed you?
What if I killed you?
It may be your problem.
Here we go. Here's the doors opening.
That was
good timing, door. Good timing, door.
Yeah, things were getting heated.
Yeah.
I almost killed you. Yeah. I had my finger hovering right over the trigger.
Did you see that Deadpool, like, friggin' commercial that was just released recently?
Whoa, Deadpool has really good marketing.
Yeah, it does. But did you see that, like, prostate cancer exam? And the tagline for it was, touch yourself tonight? It was just like, I could not stop laughing at that. I was like, I died. I literally died.
You literally died.
You could say Deadpool created a pool of dead bodies. Hey! I suck at making jokes.
Yeah, you do.
but at least I tried.
Did that, the Mario Kart race thing, do you remember that? That was good.
Yeah. I think we caught that. Oh, okay, so here's the story, in case you don't remember it, viewer. We were going through Mario Kart, we were discussing a recent issue in gaming journalism where someone was criticizing Super Mario Kart for not having any characters of color. And this joker right next to me had to say, Mario Kart isn't about race.
Yeah, I said Mario Kart's not about race. Get it?
Yeah.
It's your race.
Yeah.
It's a race.
Yeah, we're the best jokers in the world.
It is about race. It's funny, because, I don't know. To be honest, it was a total mistake when I said it, because I stopped halfway through saying race.
Whoa, I just surfed. Whoa.
I just explosions. Somehow avoided every single one of those. Okay. The bumblebee.
Run, you bastards! Look at them!
The bumblebee should totally be a black bumblebee. and I think Mario's an Italian.
Wait, shouldn't it be yellow with black stripes?
Oh, no.
Dude, this is an important issue. Do you not know? Like, it's either black with yellow stripes or yellow with black stripes. You can't get it wrong. People's lives are at stake here.
Yellow and black stripes?
No!
Why?
Because people can't be of mixed identities. That would be blasphemous. You have to be one perfect...
You're talking about bumblebees here. I'm talking about stripes.
I just killed
yellow.
You with a shotgun. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
That was me.
It, you know what? No, thank you, because then I don't have to play this level for a little bit, and I can just kind of relax and collect myself.
Oh, that was a sentinel. Sorry, I thought that was a flood literally
just
jumping down
like
into an explosion. There we go.
I should have just bellied.
Well, you know, the very first time we played through this game on Legendary together, the recording that is lost to history for very good reason, I will add. It wasn't just as superfluous my hard drive corrupted. It's a very good reason we don't have the first playthrough up, people. But anyways, we were insulting the shit out of each other, were we not?
Were we? I think so. I think we just, like, lost track of thought. The last time we were talking about this was when that stupid Joker cover came out. And that was apparently an issue, but it wasn't really.
Which Joker cover are we talking about?
Ugh, there are people talking about, is it self-censorship if someone who is the artist changes their art because
of pressure? Oh, you're talking about the Killing Joke anniversary. Yeah. Yes,
and
yeah.
And I was just like, no, if the artist wants to fucking change their thing, let them change their thing.
It's not censorship if the artist, says, okay, maybe I made a biggie here.
Yeah.
But if the artist says, I don't see the problem with this, and then you take it too far to say, you should get rid of this, then that's censorship.
Yeah, but that's not self-censorship. So the idea of self-censorship is sort of silly, because you say what you want, you have freedom of speech. I mean, I understand there's a social pressure, but there's a social pressure to literally everything you say, whether or not it's offensive. Like,
oh, that was three perfect shots in a row. I think I'm just gonna die here. I'm perfectly content with my life now. That was good. Duck and cover, bitch. And the flat and the jellyfish.
Maybe I should say more.
Oh fuck! I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I meant to aim down sights.
I'm sure you did.
I actually did.
You need to stop playing that trashy Battlefield game.
No, actually, it was Fallout 4 I was playing.
Oh. Freaking Fallout 4.
Might want to back up a bit.
Yo, Fallout, real talk, Fallout 4's sights are really bad.
Oh my god,
what?
They
came from behind. Fallout 4's sights are
I always come from behind.
I honestly think Fallout 4 would have been better without aiming down the sights.
Yeah, you know what? No, actually, I think New Vegas benefited from iron sights, because Fallout 3's aiming system was wonky without the iron
sights.
Sorry,
how about this? Fallout 4 needs to decide whether or not it wants to be aiming down the sights or being scoped. Because it can't.
Oh fuck!
Jesus, where is everything coming from, and how do I get away from it?
You're dying. Oh, you're actually being killed by jellyfish. I'll remind you.
I know. Oh god. Right on the leg.
Just use your plasma pistol. It's a more effective weapon than this shit.
No.
7 shots downs any flood form.
That's nice.
And you can fire them rapidly.
Yep.
You don't listen to my tactics. You're a meanie.
Where I'm jousting with this flow, okay? There you go. Needler.
Plasma pistol, okay, I'm set. I'll take the pistol.
There it is. Wait, hang on. There we go.
You took my shotgun.
Mind you,
I did accidentally stick you, so.
Yeah. You did. There's a shotgun for you.
Dude! You know, by calling this, this alien form the Flood, you're actually stigmatizing the flood of refugees coming out of Syria.
Oh my god.
See, this is the level of intelligent debate that I'm seeing going on around the world right now.
That's because that's the level of intelligence of the average person. Okay, maybe not the average person. But yeah, no. Blah, blah, blah. I'm offended for other people.
No, you don't have a right to say.
Is this the unlimited part? Can we just keep going?
No, actually, I think it ends at one point.
Okay, let's go.
But let's just go anyways. Because I'm a coward and I want to run.
I feel like I'm running the level backwards right now. I have no idea where I'm going.
Hold that thought.
Okay.
We need to get rid of the ones that are immediately behind us.
I wish people would stop getting offended for other people. Wouldn't that be nice?
It would be.
If people didn't assume what other people thought.
Because, I mean, people keep saying, oh, don't you feel underrepresented in the media? Lady, the last representation of my Aboriginal heritage in the media was fucking Connor in Assassin's Creed 3. I don't need any more representations like that. Oh fuck, I'm gonna die. I'm not dead!
But Connor was a well-rounded character.
No, he fucking wasn't! He's the worst.
You mean his whole identity was just that he was native?
Yeah!
Yeah.
And he spoke in the most monotone voice, too. It was just like, I am feeling emotions right now that I can never barely comprehend before. I feel like I should be betraying my country or my race, or some bullshit like that.
Yeah.
In the same monotone tone of voice.
But, still better than Ezio's original voice actor. No, sorry, not Ezio. Shit, I'll tell you. Remember him? Or... Remember his voice actor in the first one?
Actually, I do.
Oh, man, what a... Ugh.
Ah, here's a nice bit of lore. The Flood are already hard at work repairing your vessel.
Do they mean the Pillar of Autumn?
Yeah. Oh. They actually reference it in other levels, so it does build up to going back to the Pillar of Autumn. Circular themes. They work.
That's not really a circular theme. That's more of a callback.
No, the horse you rode in on.
Yeah, sure. All right, fine. I'll give you that. I'll give you that.
My point...
Oh, you killed me for a fifth time.
No, I didn't. I was aiming at the Flood.
I'm gonna spam melee attack. And if
I swear to God, I was aiming at the Flood there.
If I spawn behind you and I melee you in the back, it's your fault.
Well, I better be jumping.
Totally your fault.
This is the most fun I've had in a video game for years.
It's gone full circle. I've been bored. I've become bored of being bored. So now I'm just like fucking around. Oh.
I'm not even mad, bro.
There you go. Here's your weapons. Every time you kill me, I'm gonna do that from now. Just like attack really fast.
Did that work? No, he's still alive.
You've successfully spiked the mic again. You're right. You are the lab one. All right, let's go. Let's finish.
Yeah, this is the end of the level.
Did we get the? We didn't get the par score last level, did we?
No, probably not. I don't even care about the score. Scores in a Halo game?
I need my chibis. I need my leaderboards. I need to see who got.
I'll beat you there.
Arbitrary campaign points.
I'm beating you there.
Okay, have fun. I think I'm gonna die. No.
Yeah. Oh. Don't you love his voice when he dies? He's looking.
Okay.
There, we did it. We'll take a short break before we attempt the other levels. God.
Probably just as hard to watch.
I feel sorry for all our viewers. We could play this one at like 2x speed.
I'll just up pitch the voices until we sound like goddamn chipmunks. How about that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So 2x the speed? No, 3x the speed. Is it? Yeah. Is it? You realize how much they have to up tune those guys singing in order to actually sound like they do?
Yes.
It's actually insane.
Their voice actors and their singing actors are different.
Mm-hmm.
If you slow the voices down, they sound completely different. It's funny. Did you know the worst movie ever made was the live-action Alvin and the Chipmunks movie? It's fucking horrendous. It's awful. It makes the Smurfs look like
I've seen that movie. It's not the worst movie ever.
The Chipmunks movie?
Do you have an irrational obsession with the Chipmunks? Is that your nostalgia gag?
I feel like you missed the part where I said it's the worst thing ever.